described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Scott Peterson presents The Renaissance of Mata Ortiz. Title: Hacienda de San Diego, Chihuahua, Mexico. Someone walks across a floor. An older man in a plaid shirt, jeans, and a straw cowboy hat sits playing a fiddle. Subtitles: We ate once a day and no more. I would bring wood from the mountains to sell. That is when I got the inspiration.
The town was on its way to becoming a ghost town, drying up and blowing away.
I think that if I had not discovered the pottery industry, the population would have died out.
And my eyes fell on one of the pots, and I felt as if I was 12 or 14 inches off the ground.
It is its own art movement.
Money never crossed my mind.
The quality has just continued upward, and it's still going upward. We don't know where it's going.
The fiddler keeps playing in the hacienda. He smiles. A large bird soars in a white, cloudy sky. My name is Juan Quezada. I am 69 years old, and I am a potter. And we're on my little ranch in Mata Ortiz, Chihuahua. Farm implements hang on a barbed wire fence. Juan continues, in my town, all the people and I are dedicated to pottery. When I started this, I was about 13 or 14 years old. On one of my many trips I took to the mountains to get wood, I discovered a cave that was covered in rocks. My dear old mother used to say, one who is hungry thinks of tortillas. And when I saw this covered cave, I thought the same thing. I thought maybe there was something of value. Large birds fly over the mountain. I thought, this place could be the fountain of my life. There could be some money or hidden treasure. And so I made a hole. And the first thing I saw was a married couple. They were mummified and partly eaten by rats, the nose and the ears, and there was pottery surrounding them with the remains of food. I thought about creating something equal to it. Not a copy, but something equal to it, and I would start looking for the materials. They must have picked the materials from the same surrounding area.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.